Granny never left her house without putting on her face. She was never seen in public without full paint job. This is a tribute to my mom, who basically did lipstick and eyebrows and mascara, but I couldn't find my mascara because it's been that long since I used it. And I just put little anti-dry drops in my eyes because it's hot and dry, and it is, yeah, it's 2 p.m. and I'm just now going out to the property because I intend to be there after dark. And behind me, I have my hunting decorations because that's how I want to do it. I want to put things up in the dark and see how they look. Plus, I have real work to do until the sun goes down. So, as soon as I can no longer see tree trunks, I will start playing. Because, you know, that's why I bought the land, was so that I could have a place that could reflect who I am. And then everyone was welcome to come visit. Everyone. By invitation, please. Drop bys, not so much. First of all, because I'm never knowing if I'm there. Anyway, it's getting kind of bouncy on the road, and I need to watch where I'm going instead of whether or not this camera is actually taking a picture or not. That's what I'm doing. It'll be around close to 4 when I get there, which is, this was my thinking. I spend 3 to 4 hours staying out of the sun, doing essentially nothing. Except for it's not really nothing, because it's me meditating and thinking and, you know, doing all that in my head stuff, because that's where it originates, is in your head. And then you see if what's in your head will work. I meant to, thought maybe the universe had me a present out today at one of my favorite houses to find presents, but trash and, you know, trash has already come and it's gone. So anyway, see, distraction, squirrel. My thinking was get there when you're usually able to go back out on the property, because you always seem to run out of daylight before you run out of energy in the evening. And, oh, and I didn't put the battery on the charger properly, so it wasn't charged this morning, so I had to recharge it. Lots of stuff. Anyway, I gotta pay attention to the road. I'm coming upon 43, or whichever one this is, 43, and people drive like idiots on this road just because it's straight and country. You know, like, animals don't cross. In unexpected times. Or that just because it's country, you can do 50 on it when it's a 40-mile-an-hour road. Anyway, that's it. Bye. Okay, it's just been so long since I made this little mixed CD. But I found a new anthem with actual words that just lift me. I won't yell over her voice. But you can see there's a tiny bit of snow still there. Where's my mom? Oh, wouldn't that be wonderful if he actually showed up in the... I never can see them in the phone. Anyway, I'm almost to the land. Temperature drop and everything has reminded me that while I told myself grab my lightweight jacket, I failed. I don't even have the sweatshirt I had yesterday. So if it gets too cold on me tonight, there won't be that many decorations put up. So I'm listening to Cast in Bronze now. I'm off of 285. I don't have the stress of people on my butt or people in front of me doing something they can't handle. So I've switched over my music. Three hawks in like less than 10 minutes, 10, 11 minutes. So it's gonna be a good day. My hawks are out there everywhere today. I guess this is prime hunting time for them. Thirsty little creatures trying to get drinks at the creek, having to come out of their burrows. Anyway, I'm distracted. So, back to what I was trying to say. I do enjoy the Renaissance festivals. I have always had no problem being entertained for days at a Renaissance festival. Just the shows, the music, meeting the people. I mean, that's the coolest part of going to a Ren Fest, is actually getting to talk to the artists and the characters that are out doing the performances, because you meet some really cool people that way. Not just to romanticize one of the most oppressive moments in human history, if truth be told. But, you know, that was their life back then, and they did what they had to, just like we do today. And one of the instruments that was played, based on what the gentleman who plays it has said or claimed, was this crazy machine that he has that is literally a keyboard attached to, I guess, what would be church bells. And I don't think any of the material is new. I think it just sounds, well, this one might be new. I don't know, but it's totally cool. It's cool to watch him play it. Road trip music too. And for some reason, this time of year, from fall into winter, is when I enjoy his music the most, oddly enough. I guess because there is kind of that mysterious, haunting vibe to it, but also since it's bells, it's kind of Christmassy. That's why I like it, in case anyone cares. I'm almost to my property. Well, I'm almost to the stagecoach entrance, I should say. But I just thought I'd share a little Cast in Bronze for anyone who might want to Google Cast in Bronze and check out. fair back in Texas. So I don't know if he's even touring still. I have no clue. I just know that I heard his music and he offered me a deal I couldn't refuse, and I came home with a collection. Another perk to actually talking to the artist versus the people that, you know, are in charge of selling things. You talk to the actual artist and... Oh, wait, no, I take that back. I didn't. Oh, when the Saints come marching in. I recognize the tune now. Okay, Animate Stagecoach. Anyway, it was the sales girls that I talked to. Because they could tell that I was a pretty big fan and I really enjoyed the music, but I didn't have the money to cover all the CDs, and I guess they had been given permission in advance that they could make these really cool deals. Anyway, I got like 3 or 4 CDs for the price of 2. So it was like buy 2, get 1 or 2 free. No! I'll have to go back and count them. I think I actually got them for just a few dollars over a single CD. Mostly because, like many artists these days, he kind of sort of burns his own CDs anyway, so his cost per CD is minimal. He's not really giving a record company royalties or any, I mean, yeah, he's cut out the middleman. There you go. Which is, you know, that's how I do my business. I cut out the middleman. I got rid of Rover, who was not serving me in any capacity other than, you know, being this directory of pet care providers. And I say this based on what I told them when I left Rover, because it is obvious by the people who are requesting my services that all that information I gave, you know, my profile doesn't matter. There you go. No one's paying any attention. Desperate people desperately trying to dump off animals, which, if anyone knows me, that is like, no, you don't dump off an animal. It's why I'm starting an old dog care sanctuary, because people dump off their old dogs and they expect the compassion of humane societies to deal with them, or, you know, I guess it's just like that emperor that washed his hands and said, I'm not guilty of this man's death. Oh gosh. I know the name. It's just not coming out. Anyway, yeah, that seems to be part of a human thing. I'll just wash my hands of it by, if I get rid of it, then it's no longer my responsibility. There you go. That's how I see it. And I've never been that person. And I hope I never become that person. And anyone watching this who is that person, you're probably going to unsubscribe from my channel. But I'm okay with that. Property. No! So, I got some oil put in the chainsaw. Decided where I was going to start. Walked into the woods. Walked into them. Walked. And, yeah. A little branch did that to me. A little branch. So here's my first aid kit. This is equal parts rubbing alcohol and hydrogen peroxide. And that's masking tape, of which I will make a bandage out of. Once upon a time, I had a roll of electrical tape in here, but I don't anymore. Which makes me wonder where I put it. Maybe it's in any of this other stuff. Because, you know, this was supposed to be my garage. Well, I take that back. This was supposed to be my she shed slash office slash puppy dog house. My garage was supposed to be over there. But I can't have a garage until I have a house. Which to me is insane, but I don't run Park County. And although it wasn't funny at the time, it is now, because sometimes I'll hear my ex's voice. Girls aren't supposed to like to do stuff like that. Or, you want to be a man. Because I did like to do things like this. Now it's funny. Back then, it was just one more reason for me to go, who did I marry?